Mr. President.
Yeah.
I wanted to let you know we found the car.
Yeah.
Now, this is not known. Nobody knows this at all. But the car was burned, and we do not know yet whether any bodies are inside of the car because of the intense heat that still is in the area of the car. The license plates on the car are the same that was on the car that was in Philadelphia, Mississippi yesterday. And apparently, this is off to the side of the road. It wasn't going toward Meridian, but it's going in the opposite direction. Now, whether there anybody's in the car, we won't know until we can get into the car ourselves. We've got agents, of course, on the ground, and as soon as we get definite word, I'll, of course, get word to you. But I did want you to know that apparently what's happened, these men have been killed. Although, as I say, we can't tell whether anybody's in there in view of the intense heat.
Well, now, what would make you think they've been killed?
Because of the fact that it is the same car that they were in Philadelphia, Mississippi. And the same license number is on the outside of the car. Now, as I say, the heat is so intense you can't tell on the inside that everything's been burned, whether there are any charred bodies or not. It is merely an assumption that probably they were burned in the car. On the other hand, they may have been taken out and killed on the outside.
Or maybe kidnapped and locked up.
How's that?
Or maybe kidnapped and locked up.
Well, I would doubt whether those people down there would even give them that much of a break. But, of course, we're going to go into that very thoroughly. Not only as to the fact as to whether they're still alive. If they're not in the car, then they may have been killed and their body's buried in one of those swamps down there.
Where did you find the car? How far from Philadelphia?
The car was about 8 miles from Philadelphia, but not in the direction of Meridian. It was in the opposite direction. Now, they had left Philadelphia, according to the reports that we had earlier, to go to Meridian, which is about 20 miles. This, however, was on State Highway 21, and the car was off to the side of the highway, although it could be seen from the highway. And an Indian agent, there's an Indian reservation down in that area, although the car is not on the reservation. An Indian agent saw the car and immediately notified us, and we went there, and there we found this condition.
How long has the car been burnt, you reckon? 6-8 hours?
Well, we frankly don't know. The intense heat would have indicated that the car probably had been burning for maybe 6 hours or 5 or 6 hours.
What would you indicate? They filled with gasoline and...
I would think so, yes. There wasn't any indication of any explosion like dynamite or anything of that kind. And, of course, dynamite wouldn't have caused the intense heat and fire that kerosene or gasoline would have.
Well, looks like those fellas jumped out of the car and burned it.
Well, you would think they would unless they'd been bound and were locked in that car and then the car set a fire.
Well, why wouldn't an agent be able to look at the car and see if there's any bones in it?
See whether there are any bodies in it?
Any bones, yeah.
Well, the reason for that is the car is so burned and charred with heat that you can't get close to it. Except that we did get the license number, which is on the outside of the car.
You mean it's still burning?
Well, the car is still burning, yes.
You mean you think this happened in the last few minutes? Then?
No, I don't think it's the last few minutes. I think it's happened within the last maybe 5 or 6 hours. You see, they didn't leave there until sometime yesterday, I think it was.
Okay, you call me as soon as you can.